Hello. Welcome to a new RandoMixer tutorial. Here's a desk, some office accessories and a computer. We'll learn how to distribute these elements on the desk and produce many different variants for an office interior scene. A simple option might be to use this powerful tool we saw in another tutorial. Auto-populate furniture. This gave us a very fast and acceptable result. The matter is that in this case we need more precision to better position the computer monitor and keyboard. And we also need a way to store and manage different variants of this composition. So we'll start by leaving only the computer elements on the desk and manually position properly. Now, with a line tool, we can draw a specific area where to scatter the other objects. Then convert it to editable poly. Let's create a master icon to start working with a collection of variants. Now we create a new set with the accessories and give it a name. Let's activate the scatter function and load the new surface as a distribution set. We will use this integrated version of the auto-populate furniture tool we previously tried. Let's create a collection of 20 variants. This looks pretty good already. Now we can switch to multiple sets mode. Here's the set random mixer automatically created when we added the distribution surface at the scatter section. Let's name it surface. Now we go to edit the element properties and turn on this invisible property. This way the surface remains active but hidden. Nice. Let's add a little bit of chaos to make it look more natural. We'll add some rotation in Z-axis. Remember to set the anchor point to base when dealing with objects placed on a flat surface. Great. Now let's include the computer elements and the chair's new sets, so we can apply these random transforms to them too. Let's check all settings a bit. And create a new collection. This is getting better, isn't it? Now we'll add more variation by hiding some of the elements each time. We go to edit the set properties and change the amount of active objects per frame by setting a minimum and a maximum number. Let's see the changes. We can delete unwanted frames or edit them. There are nice looking variations now. Okay. Let's reveal our office environment. On the floor, there are some yellow shapes indicating how to distribute the desks. They should go like this. But, instead of tediously cloning the objects, randomizing transforms and deleting some of the elements to manually generate variation. We will spread the collection of variants we just created, as separate clones, in the right places. Let's draw independent marks to easily position every desk. We will use the pivots of these rectangles for placing our clones. But before turning our variants into clones, we need to add the desk and drawers too. Let's exclude them from the transforms. We don't want them to rotate. I will create only 10 variants this time. We only need 8 clones of our desk. Let's delete some unwanted frames. Now we are ready. Let's try this wonderful tool. RandoMixer lets you take a snapshot of a range of frames. It's not a 3ds Max snapshot. It makes instances of the elements in every frame and builds a 3ds Max group with them. Here are all the snapshots, 8 groups in total. Let's turn off all the functions and clear the interface. Now we load all the groups into the plugin. They are named like the master icon plus the collection frame number. This time we will use another scatter function. We will load the rectangles as a distribution set. But first make sure to turn on the shapes filter. Otherwise they will be ignored. Choose place at pivots option. And anchor point, base. As you can see, we have now all our desk variants nicely laid out in the right places. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. See you in the next one.